हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 8, वेलकम टू फिजिक्स क्लास। एंड टुडे वी विल लर्न एंड डिस्कस ऑन सोलर सिस्टम। सोलर सिस्टम द सन इज एट द फोसाई एंड अदर 8 प्लैनेट्स आर ऑर्बिटिंग अबाउट इट इन देयर पर्टिकुलर ऑर्बिटल पाथ। Not only 8 planets, the asteroids, comets, meteors, and also satellites of planets are the members of solar family. In solar family, the planets, Mercury is the nearest, whereas Neptune is the farthest. The solar system, the sun and the celestial bodies which revolve around it form the solar system. It consists of large number of bodies such as planets, comets, asteroids and meteors. The gravitational attraction between the sun and these objects keep them revolving around it. You know, the gravitational attraction of the star sun is much maximum in the solar system, and this gravitational pull of the sun with the planets keep them moving in the orbital path. Not only the planets, the asteroids also are in the gravitational field of the sun. You know, gravitational pull or the force acts between any two objects in the universe. So the celestial bodies also exert gravitational force on each other. For these gravitational force, the planets revolve around the sun, the satellites move about the planet. The Earth, as you know, also revolves around the sun, and it is a member of solar system having life. There are 7 other planets that revolve around the sun, and the 8th planet is their order of distance from the sun are Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus and Neptune. Till 2006, there were 9 planets in the solar system. Pluto was the furthest planet from the sun. In 2006, IAU adopted a new definition of a planet. Pluto does not fit this definition. It is no longer a planet of the solar system. It is known as dwarf planet. Now, why Pluto is not considered as a planet? IAU adopted 3 points or criteria to fulfill a definition of planet. First one, it should revolve around the sun in the particular orbit. Number 2, it has definite mass. And number 3, it should have clear orbital neighborhood. That means the celestial body will not share its orbital space with any other celestial objects. Pluto does not fit the third point for the definition of the planet. Pluto shares its orbital space with other celestial bodies. Not only that, Pluto is a member of Kuiper Belt, the belt where celestial objects like Pluto, which are spherical in shape, revolving around the sun. There are thousands and millions of such celestial bodies in the Kuiper Belt, and Pluto is the largest member of this Kuiper Belt. That means the orbital space is not clear. That is why Pluto is considered as a dwarf planet. The size of the Pluto is also small than that of the other planet, even Mercury. Even the moon of the Pluto also as that of the same size of that Pluto. So they orbit each other or revolve each other like a binary planets. That is why Pluto is not considered as a planet. Let us know about some members of solar family. So first of all is the Sun. The Sun is the nearest star from us. It is continuously emitting huge amount of heat and light. The Sun is the source of almost all energy of the Earth. In fact, Sun is the main source of heat and light for all the planets. About Sun, we learned in previous class. The planets look like stars in the night sky, but they do not have their own light. Actually, they get light from the sun and reflect the sunlight that falls on them. So, can you distinguish between planets and stars? The simplest method of identifying planets from stars is that stars twinkle whereas planets do not. Also, the planets keep changing their position with respect to the stars. A planet has a definite path in which it revolves around the sun. This path is called an orbit. The time taken by a planet to complete one revolution is called its period of revolution. The period of revolution increases as the distance of the planet increases from the sun. Besides revolving around the sun, the planets also rotate on its axis like a top. The time taken by a planet to complete one rotation is called its period of rotation. Now, students, the orbital period and the revolution period are different for different planets. Orbital period is not same for all the planets. I wonder why the planets do not collide while revolving around the Earth. Because the planets have their own orbits which do not intersect with any other, so there is no chance of colliding with other planets while revolving around the Earth. Now, the orbital path, that is the orbit, is not a circular. It is a quite elliptical shape, where Sun is at the focus of the ellipse. That means the shape is like quite oval shape also, you can say. Now, the orbital path shape are not same for all the planets. It differs. Planets rotates about their own axis. Different planets take different time interval to complete one rotation. Like Jupiter, the period of rotation is minimum, where 9 hours and 55 minutes. You see, Jupiter is the largest planet, but it takes less time to rotate about its axis, that means it is so fast, whereas Venus takes 243 days, whereas Earth takes one day, that is 24 hours. This is the Earth day. Planets also have their natural satellites. Some planets have more than one satellite. Our natural satellite is the moon, you know. Some planets are known to have moons or satellites revolve around them. The body which revolves around another celestial body is called its satellite. The Earth can be said to be a satellite of the Sun. Though generally we call it a planet of the Sun. We use the term satellite for the bodies revolving around the planet. So, moon is a satellite of the Earth. The earth revolve around the sun. Does it make earth a satellite of the sun? Actually, it is not. It is a planet. There are many man-made satellites revolving around the earth. These are called artificial satellites. Next, astronomy in India. The practice of astronomy in ancient India is mentioned in Rig Veda, which was composed about 4000 years ago. Student, this part is very important. This part gives us the information about the ancient astronomers and their intelligence. Many Indian scholars have contributed to astronomy. One of the most well-known astronomers is Aryabhatta. The work of Aryabhatta on astronomy can be found in his writing Aryabhatiya. He wrote it in 499 CE at the age of 23 years. The diameter of the earth as stated by Aryabhatta is close to its presently known value. So he was a good mathematician also. Disregarding the popular view that earth is achala, that means immovable, Aryabhatta stated that earth is sphere and rotate on its own axis. So earth is spherical shape. It is much before said by Aryabhatta than Magellan. He estimated about the sidereal period of earth was 23 hours, 52 minutes and 4.1 seconds, which is very close to the presently known value. So, on that very time when no such devices were discovered by calculation and mathematics, he and by his intelligence, he estimated the period of the earth. He also correctly stated that the moon and the planet shine due to reflected sunlight. He also gave a scientific explanation for solar and lunar eclipses. When the shadow of the earth falls on the moon, it causes lunar eclipse, and when the shadow of the moon falls on the earth, it causes solar eclipse. On that very time, so many myths were there, but Aryabhatta said the proper scientific reason for solar eclipse and lunar eclipse. Aryabhatta also found the distance between the earth and the moon, which is very close to the known value today. So, dear student, you can imagine, now you can think, at that very time our ancient astronomer Aryabhatta was so intelligent. The planet Mercury. The planet Mercury is nearest to the sun. It is the smallest planet of our solar system. Because Mercury is very close to the sun, it is difficult to observe it, as most of the time it is hidden in the glare of the sun. However, it can be observed just before sunrise or just after sunset near the horizon. So it is visible only at places where trees or buildings do not obstruct the view of horizon. Mercury has no satellite of its own. Now, Mercury is the nearest planet to the sun. It takes 88 days to revolve around the sun, and it has no atmosphere, so the glare, heat and light of the sun reflect from the surface of the Mercury. And so temperature is very high, about 520 degree centigrade. And the other side which do not get light is about minus 175 degree centigrade. And so for this high temperature, there is no sign of life on the Mercury. Next, Venus. You know, Venus is the Earth's nearest planetary neighbor, and it is the brightest planet in the night sky, and it is also known as Shuktara. Its size is nearly equal to the Earth. It completes one revolution in 225 days. And Venus has a atmosphere which is thin, and mostly carbon dioxide is there, and oxygen and water vapor is also there. You know, carbon dioxide, water vapor are the greenhouse gases for which it trap the heat of the sun. So it is the hottest planet in the planetary system of the sun, and it is also brightest planet. Because of the presence of the carbon dioxide, it traps the heat of the sun, and the atmosphere of Venus reflects most of the sunlight falling on it, so it appears brightest object in the sky after the sun and the moon. Next, Venus has no moon or satellite of its own. Rotation of Venus on its axis is somewhat unusual. It rotates from east to west, while Earth rotates from west to east. We can see Venus in the western sky just after sunset. Therefore, it is also known as morning star or evening star. Next, the Earth. The Earth is the only planet in the system on which life is known to some special environment condition are responsible for the existence and continuation of life on the Earth. These include just the right distance from the sun, so it has the right temperature and presence of water and suitable atmosphere, and a blanket of ozone. For these, life exists here. So we must take special care to protect our environment so that life on the Earth is not disturbed. From space, the Earth appears blue-green due to reflection of light from the water and landmass on its surface. The axis of rotation of the Earth not perpendicular to the plane of its orbit. The tilt is responsible for the change of season on the Earth. The Earth has only one moon. If you get a chance, if I am a 13 years old, how many times have I gone around the Earth, around the sun? That means 13 times. Mars, the next planet and the first outside the orbit of the Earth, is Mars. It appears slightly reddish, and therefore it is also called red planet. Mars has two small natural satellites. And you know very well, scientists from different countries are in the quest of life on the surface of the Mars. And for these, many satellites are sent by different countries which are orbiting about the Mars for collecting information or getting trace of life or water on the red planet. Mars has a very thin atmosphere, mainly consists of nitrogen and oxygen, You know one spacecraft sent by NASA, that is Curiosity, still moving on the surface of the Mars and collecting information about the atmosphere and the surface and soil of the Mars to get a trace of water on the Mars, so that in future life can be settled on the surface of the Mars. Mangalyaan, Indian Space Research Organization ISRO, launched India's first Mars orbiter mission Mangalyaan on November 5, 2013. It was successfully placed into an orbit of Mars on September 24, 2014, with this, India became the first country in the world to do so in its first attempt. Not only that, with a minimum cost. Jupiter. Is the largest planet of the solar system. It is so large that about 1300 Earth can be placed inside this giant planet. However, the mass of the Jupiter is about 318 times that of the Earth. It rotated very rapidly on its axis. Jupiter has a large number of satellites. It has faint rings like that of the Saturn, and you can easily recognize Jupiter as it appears quite bright in the sky. If you observe it with the help of telescope, you can see four of its large moons also. The colors appears on the Jupiter's surface are the cyclone of gas. Most distinguishing feature of the Jupiter is its red spot, and it is believed to be the storm in its atmosphere. And Jupiter has 28 moons. So dear student, next day we will learn about other planets and artificial satellites. Thank you. আজকে অনেকটা